Respected friends, in this summer we experienced numerous building fires and then the issue of fire protection of buildings has come on anvil. In Development Control and Promotion Regulations for Declared Municipal Corporation in Maharashtra. In Regulation Number 43.7, there are some clauses regarding electrical services has to conform to some wiring details, which I will read out and discuss. Because this is a basic document before granting permission for occupation by the local municipal corporation to the building owner. And these fire protection requirements, I think, might have a certificate of fire officer, might have been required, that I do not know. I do not know whose certificate municipal corporation asked for these purposes. However, I will read out the provisions. The regulation number 43.7 says, A. The electric distribution cables, wiring, shall be laid in a separate duct. The all should not be in one duct. The duct shall be sealed at every floor with non-combustible materials having the same fire resistance as that of the duct. Very important point. Low and medium voltage wiring running in shaft and in false ceiling shall run in separate conduits. B. Water mains, telephone lines, intercom lines, gas pipes, or any other service line shall not be laid in the duct for electrical cables. This is very important. Use of bus ducts, solid rising main instead of cable is preferred. Separate circuits for firefighting pumps. In case there is a fire, the circuits for firefighting pumps, lifts, staircases and corridor, lighting and blowers for pressurizing system shall be provided directly from the main switch gear panel, and this circuit shall be laid in separate conduit pipes so that fire in one circuit will not affect the others. Such circuits shall be protected at origin by an automatic circuit breaker with its non-hold coil removed. Master switches controlling essential circuits shall be clearly labeled. D. The inspection panel doors and any other opening in the shaft shall be provided with airtight fire doors having fire resistance of not less than 2 hours. Medium and low voltage wiring running in shafts and within false ceiling shall run in metal conduit. Any 230 volt wiring for lighting or other services shall above false or other services above false ceiling shall have 660 volt grade insulation. The false ceiling, including all fixtures used for its suspension, shall be of non-combustible material. and shall provide adequate fire resistance to the ceiling in order to prevent spread of fire across the ceiling. Reference may be made to good practice. An independent and well-ventilated service room shall be provided on the ground level or first basement with direct access from outside or from corridor for the purpose of termination of electric supply from the licensee, service and alternative supply cables. The doors provided for the service room shall have fire resistance of not less than 2 hours. Note, if service room is locked at the basement, it should have automatic fire extinguisher system. G. If the licensee agrees to provide meters on upper floors, the licensee's cable shall be segregated from consumer's cables by providing a partition in the duct. Meter rooms on upper floors shall not open into staircase enclosures and shall be ventilated directly to open air outside. And yet, suitable circuit breakers shall be provided at the appropriate points. I think these provisions are fireproof. Only the work shall be done in practice according all these items so that there will not be any fire to the buildings. Respected sir, the experts, those who are carrying out fire audit of the buildings, may guide us in this regard. What are their actual observations in fire audit, so that there will be some discussion and the building owners will also be aware for getting the work done to the mark to avoid electrical fires and further loss to them and nation. Myself, Ramdas Chandrakade, retired Chief Engineer and National Safety Council member. Kindly subscribe to my this video if you like it, and for the purpose of spreading electrical safety awareness, please. Thank you.